Hey, welcome back, everybody. Cy here again with another episode. And, well, what have I been doing? Well, more furnaces. I got a bunch of ore. Well, technically a bunch. Off camera. And, sheared myself up some leaves. Got more seeds. I found chance cubes. Well, I found one chance cube that turned into four chance cubes and an icosahedron, which turned in. One of those chance cubes turned in another four chance cubes and an icosahedron. I ended up getting actually a decent amount of stuff. Like an entire suit of iron armor with an iron sword. Brand new, so into the smeltery she went. Could recoup some of those resources anyway. Let's get all that. Another one I found gave me a cake, which I found out you can actually break these things and pick them up now. I'm not sure which mod adds that, but that's cool. Because normally vanilla, you can't pick them up again. I got a tuberous flux capacitor. I got a useless generator, which is, a pink generator, which I'm just gonna toss here behind my survivalist I made. One piece of coal, by the way, filled it up to 80,000 RF. This thing runs on pink stuff. Will it work on pink stained glass wall? No, it will not. Even though they're from the same damn mod. It won't do it. Are there any uses for these? No, there are not. All right, well, figure in the meantime, though, I will go through because here we go. Eight of these things, right? That'll work out perfect. Okay, I'm gonna have to do the little jumpy place thing. These ore berry bushes, or the essence berry bushes, don't have, ouch, a minimum light level. Or maximum light level, I should say. Like the regular ore berry bushes. These guys will grow in any light level, which is great. Because these are future inventory slots, right here. They grow the berries. We usually get two or three per growth. Did I ever. I don't. Did I make my watering can finally? Oh, and don't sort your inventory with inventory tweaks or a infinite invo on. It does some bad things. Found a couple spawners while I was out too. Got two Ender Swords. Found some of the Lady Ustra ore. So I've got six of these fabulous diamonds now. I've got 11 diamonds, four emeralds. Got some more copper, some lead, block of quartz from the chance cubes. I would have gotten more, but the damn things were underwater. So, yeah. Got a couple squid, which is good. Ink sacks. Let me turn you into black dye as well. And I think, yeah, here we go. Let's see. What else we got going on here? Okay, well, you're growing. Yeah, that one's already grown. That's cool. Got my three chickens down there, which is awesome. Got some more string, which is great. I was breaking cobwebs, actually. I was running for my life from any and every enemy that decided to come my way. Just, I didn't want necessarily running for my life, just conflict avoidance. I just didn't want to deal with their bastards, so I didn't. Like, you guys can just stay here. I've got this traveler's vest with swift sam swim. There we go, swift swim. Thank you. And I was mainly exploring water. Is it going to show up on my map, or am I too high up? Here we go. Here's a good portion of it, but I actually, yeah, down here, this is where I ended up. There's a piece of shiny ore there, which I didn't bring any SDX with me, so I wasn't able to get that one. But I do have two pieces that I found previously. So let's put that away, I guess, as well. Put the iron in there. And now I believe it's like quest time, isn't it? I will worry about unscrewing my inventory later. Because it happened again. Oh, and I got snowman in a wand, and I got flint and steel. Starts fires at a distance, chills things at a distance. It was a quest reward, like fire and ice or something. Or not quest reward, chance cube. And it said like fire and ice or something like that. One, two. I got some bacon Russian burgers, which are already 40% rotten. Great. Raw calamari, but I can use this as an ingredient. I can cook it if need be and reset the food timer on it. And I think I might have to do. Ooh. Wait a second, bakeware. I do have bakeware. So when these things get close to rotting, I can just turn them into like fish sticks. Good to know. Good to know. Actually, let's just grab this stuff now. Get my flour. And you are going to just kind of sit and chill right there for now. Yep, fish sticks. Awesome. Let's see. Was there anything else I wanted out of here? Excuse me, I still have these damn fireworks. Yeah, let's grab the only one I'm out of here too, I guess, and we'll put that away. That chest is already full. Wow. All right, see, I was looking up shiny, and it's an ardite level pick required to dig it. Thing is, I have a quest for a QDD, and that'll let me triple ores, right? Was it for science had it? Yeah. If one piece of ore, one piece of coal will triple it, which I'm not too worried about most of the ores. Seems like a really good idea to hold off on doing anything like shiny until I can triple it, because this stuff is rare. But let's see, I lava you, turn in 8 buckets of lava. I'm gonna get Schletlinks, there we go. Drink a malted liquor that is totally just juice. And a hard hat. Not sure what the hard hat will stop falling block damage. Okay, that could be cool. I usually don't have to worry about that because I keep it nourishing light meal. Member of Noodlecraft. Okay. Shetlink. What are you anyway? Two haunches? Yeah, whatever. I usually don't get myself into a situation where I have to worry about it. Now, more space. I need a portable tank, which I have right there. I have to turn it in. And then I need fused quartz. Well, let's see. Just get rid of this for now. Fused quartz, right? Fused quartz frame, fused quartz blast resistant. Can only be done in an alloy smelter. So that is something for the future. Can't do that right now. Slime balls. Turn in a water bucket, a flower, and 16 lapis to get 4 spawn blue slime eggs. And it is a repeatable quest, which is ready to be done again. So cool, right? Why is the baby on fire? Redstone furnace. I hope that this is fuzzy because I cannot make a resonant right now. No way, no how. Let's see. Setting up shop. Oh, yes, our storage wars thing. Upgrades. I need 4 wool. No, I have enough to make 2 wool right now. Bit unfortunate. Crossroads, turn in 2 of these to get. I do want the golden bag, but I don't want another infinity water bucket. So that's going to hold off for now. Where is my mind? I need a dandelion and a poppy. I have grass spreading outside, which there's not been a lot of booms, so I think it's still intact. This just, I have to have this in my inventory and I can claim more snowballs. I've got 16 of them so far. I'm not terribly worried about it. Noah's Ark and Company, kill some spiders. I've been avoiding them, so but I'm going to need more string. But I'm going to do mob hunting off camera. This quest has opened up, however, or this section. Which, yeah, feeling lucky, right? So, creeper's gonna creep. If I turn in 10 gunpowder, I get a chance icosahedron. 5 blank records, I get 3 of them. Spoiled milk bucket. Just have it on me, nonetheless, which is nice. Those who came before, detection. The coffee. Ingy the ingot. Walking wounded headband and panda burrs, panda mask. Okay. Golden egg times 1. Interesting. And I get 2 of them. So this is just a way to get chance icosahedrons, which are like beefed up chance cubes. But yeah, it's something else to work towards. Survival, 6 quests. So aged macaroons. I got this thing from a chance cube, so but this was just a detection quest, which means let's see. Decided you couldn't leave home without bringing your mom's macaroon recipe down here. No, that's not a type of nut. Seriously, look it up on Google. I'll wait. But there is, there's macaroon nuts, and then there's macaroon cookies, which are amazing. I'm gonna go ahead and claim that and yoink. Thank you. Let's just drink this for now. Thank you. Oh, got a glass bottle back. All right, cool. And a quarter of a heart, which I do not need. So that is now completed. Excellent. 8 cooked eggs. Yep. Thanks a melon. This is what I needed the black dye for. So black dye, 2 seeds. Is that... That is a repeatable quest as well. So just... As many melons as I want. Okay, I'm going to claim that. The reason of... These are going to go here and sit here and spoil. And then a melon block. Alright, cool. Let's put the black dye away too, I guess. Because I need, for one of the Feeling Lucky quests, I need 16 spoiled food. He who dealt it, cooking for blockheads, saucepan. Now I need to make the cooking for blockheads 2. So I need this. I need 2 of you. And I need my crafting bench. Dang it. Alright, and I need 2 crafting tables. 1, 2. So I think it was like so, and you in the middle? Yes. Cooking for blockheads 2. Can craft food using the things you have in your inventory. And it gets me, ta-da, a skillet. Which can go in there for now, because the next thing I'm working on, and the kitchen sink. Congratulations on you, cooking for blockheads kitchen set. Cooking has never been so easy. Just place the kitchen items directly next to each other, and they will act as a multi-block structure. The fridge will hold items, place your food inside. All the Pam's Harvest Craftware or Harvest Craft cookware can be added for extra functionality, either by hanging it from a tool rack or in their designated oven spot. Start crafting food, use the cooking table. Make sure to supply the oven with fuel. Or you can just cook things manually outside of it. But I need a cooking table, a cooking oven, and a sink. Alright. I am just going to kind of cut out the middleman here. I'm just going to look up blockheads. Right. There's everything we need. Okay, the sink. Bucket of water. Wood blocks and some iron ingots. All right. Well, think in here. No, it's in the black bag. I have 4 buckets. So I'm just going to take one of you. And I got the wood. All right, cool. 1, 2, 3. All right. So we're going to go like there, that, and there. Is our sink. Now I think, let's just do that and that. Here's good, right? Oh, hell. That is a lot of rumbling. The last time that happened, I had a freaking ravine open up. So, hello tree. Actually, let's go take a look at that while I'm thinking about it, right? The ravine, the one that I saw from the surface going, oh, wow, I must have just barely missed that damn thing. No, I didn't. Remember that pathway I dug through? Here. Wait a second. Is that another? That is another oreberry bush right there. I didn't even see that one. Yeah. So you can see I plundered the bottom of the ravine, kind of, sort of. Obsidianized all of it. By the way, obsidian will fall into the lava underneath it, so be careful. Scares the hell out of you the first time that happens. God, the rumbling. But that's where I got the Ustra ore. I got some Ender obsidian, or Ender amethyst. I got all the obsidian I could ever want down there. Let's see the... Whoop. Bunch of diamonds, and... Something I'm not too happy about. Sometimes diamond ore will turn into lava when you mine it. Happened to me twice. Only on diamond. But still, happened twice. Not amused. Next. Sorry. Oven. Furnace. Black stained glass. Alright. I knew there's a reason I made extra sand. Nope. Yes, you do in here. I'm going to take, kind of divvy up your fuel though. All right. And then a cooking table is black stained clay. Damn. There goes like most of my built up resources. But yeah, plenty of apples. I got a lot of things grown over here now, which is a good start, right? I mean, it's not a great thing, but it's a good thing. Now I have to wait for all 8 of those glass and the 8 hardened clay to cook up. All right, what are we at? 17 ingots left. Wow. It's actually quite a nice windfall getting that armor. That's quite a bit of iron. I'm gonna need a lot of iron too, so. If for nothing else, then a stupid alloy smelter. All right, dynamic lights. You're pissing me off still. Just do this. I need 4 blocks of iron for the alloy smelter. Let's actually look that up. We go. That's everything. Cooking blockheads and the alloy smelter. So I need a cauldron, which is standard. Awesome. I need 4 blocks of iron, 3 furnaces, and a machine chassis, which is 8 steel and some iron bars. Oh, God. Why iron bars? They stack for crap. Although they just take up inventory space, I guess, my main complaint. How much steel do I have? I have 3. How am I going to get more steel? There is another pig iron ore will turn into steel. That's cool. I'm not in the nether yet. Smelting another pig iron ore. It does give you 2 of them. That's kind of cool. QED recipe, stone furnace, induction smelter. Casting table. Okay, well, casting table. How do I get molten steel out of you? Steel parts and chain. Well, I guess I can turn. All right, you turn into 2 for the chain chest. I guess I can turn iron in a roundabout way into steel. Okay, you take 4 and you turn into 1. All right, leggings turn into 2 and for 7. So I think leggings are my best bet. That's gonna be a lot of iron I go through. It's gonna be so much iron. Okay, you done? Not that one. There and there. And now I'm going to need. Where are they at? Ink sacs times 2. Cool. All right, let's do this. Right. We go. There's my black stained clay, my black glass. The oven is also a furnace, which actually had enough on me, it looks like. Oh well. Now I have more. Like so, and there is my oven. The cooking table is now this book, some of that clay, and some of this wood. Right? There we go. Whoop. And okay, that was a crafting task. Thank God. Claim the reward. And we'll get you porn, I guess, too. There goes the oven, cooking table, the fridge, which I can make more. It's just a chest and an iron door. And where did my. There we go. My tool racks. Tool rack, tool rack. Oh my God! Knock it off! Freaking cave-ins everywhere around here. All right, and you, I am gonna just pick and throw in here so you can grow another one if you want. Do 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 do. Where are you at? 57%. Damn. Did that unlock anything else though? No, it didn't. Okay. So, but in the meantime, I am going to grab things like that. Go over here to my oven, which I do love this mod. This mod is awesome. There goes the pot, our bakeware, the saucepan, and let's see. Let's put our mortar and pestle there. Ah, good, it's working right this time. Kinda. Juicer. And I had a skillet for a quest reward, didn't I? So let's go find that now. Put it in there. All right, there's my skillet and my cutting board. I think that's it. There's 8 tools. So we got 4 on the rack. We have 4 in the oven. We should be good. Oh yes, and the whole thing's animated. So you do that. And I believe the sink actually. Cool, you right click on it, it goes drip and it drips. Cool. I believe the sink lets you make, yep, unlimited fresh water, which is awesome. Let's go ahead and make those up now. We're going to toss that and that in there. It's not an esky, though, which is a downside. Esky from Enviromine. The diamond chest, snow blocks, and iron ingots. That slows down food rotting, I want to say. So I don't think this does, though, which would be nice if it did, but as cheap as it is, I don't think it's going to really help a whole lot. Questing, no. Okay, so I did turn in a block of gold. And actually, I got a golden apple for a quest reward. That sucker went in there. That gave me 8 ingots of gold. So it is what it is. Reward bag, iron tool rod, and a paper binding. The thing is, I've already put a paper binding on my pick. And that's about the only thing that uses paper bindings. I've got a steel tool rod on the knives and an iron knife blade. So that tool rod does me no good either. And our good bag is probably going to destroy our inventory. It's a bunch of gold. All right. And apparently I had enough inventory space for it. All right, knock me down with the damn feather. Golden horse armor. Can I smelt it into gold? Yes, I can. Awesome. So there's that. The gold ore, I'm just going to toss in a chest, I guess. Because I can duplicate that later on, I think. So, or double it or whatever. Maybe not duplicate it. Duplicate's a little misleading, I think. All right. So I need iron chains, huh? Okay, I'm going to do it. Oh, cool. I got enough sticks just sitting here. Iron diamond hammer. That's a bit painful. That was really painful. I actually used a couple diamonds for that. The iron, not too concerned about it. I can get more give, thank you, relatively easily. 64 of you. That's 18 ingots of steel right there. Really should make like a casting basin, I think. There we go. This should be my steel worries taken care of for a while. Iron's not that hard to come by, so I'm not too worried about it, but I did kind of just clean myself out of iron pretty good there. Okay, you can go in here. I have 2 seer bricks. I need 5 more. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And clay is not that hard to come by. So, but hopefully, yeah, that'll give us 8 grout. So that can go in there. I've got 1 chain patch left. What can I do? Can I do anything with you? No, not really. I can just make armor out of you. All right. And it's so light, it's hard to see against the gray. All right, steel be done. Let's start pulling steel here. 2, 3, yeah, 4. I'm gonna pull 9 out because that way it leaves exactly a block in there for me to pull at a later date. Oh crap, forgot where's that. Okay, 3 more. I could have just looked at how many I have in my hand. Derf. 8 and 9. All right, cool. I am actually going to grab a bacon mushroom burger to eat. Thank you. Did I put my... Okay, the steel bars are still on me. Iron bars, whatever they are. These annoyances. All right. Machine chassis. Awesome. Just give me a stack of that. 1, 2, 3, and I need a cauldron, don't I? I need 3 more iron. Okay, I got 5 in there. All right, we're good. 1, 2, 3. Good. I'm just getting one more pouring while I'm away. Oh, man. I am not, no, so iron poor. Not even funny. I'm glad I got as much as I did earlier, so. Alloy smeltery. Awesome, right? So now you, I'm going to move, because. Are you going to connect straight away? You are. Cool, that helps, actually. That can go there. Take another cursory inspection for anything pink. I'm not really seeing anything. I mean, that's pink. Maybe one of these strips is too, but micro blocks I don't think will work. That's the problem with fences is they're actually a micro block structure. Drink of water there. Put that away. Main reason I'm doing this is I wanted to check out my my essence berry bushes. Which I had the original two. There we go, I got three more. Up to level 11 already. These things are going to be great for solving inventory problems. Okay. So, I'm not seeing. In the top left of my map over there is where my grass is. I'm not seeing any passive mobs show up yet, though. But, okay, so that one is done. The bomb squad, I need 8 TNT, which means I need a grand total of 40 gunpowder, which I don't have yet. But I get 4 Mystical Lady Osto, or XP tank. Oh, yes, block of aluminum. There we go, and definitely have enough aluminum to do this with now. Come on. Block it. Thank you. And submit. Get a liquid XP tank, four ferrous ingots, and a quarter of a heart. So let's claim that. Let's put our ferrous away. Liquid XP tank. I'm gonna just slap you here for now. Because I need 20 levels. And I'm gonna unlock a slot. And I'm going to start drinking more out of you. I think I need 22 now. Unlock a slot. And I'm just gonna chuck the rest, which will get me to level 11. Awesome. That was actually a pretty good quest reward. I appreciated that one. And next, we need shiny ingots for this one. I am waiting till I can multiply my ore a bit more, though. For science. Okay, now what does this one need again? This needs slime crystal, blue one, and rubber saplings. So actually, let's claim this. Spawn you in. Am I? Oh, I am, because I was. Okay, let's try this again. Whoops. Supposed to be hard. There we go. No, I was doing some testing in a copy. And, yep. Forgot to change it back. So I wasted a slime egg there. Or, oh well. You're dead. Cool. You're dead. Ow. You're dead. Give me that. And. Cool, I keep getting big ones. This is nice, actually. Ow. Cool, more of those berries. Awesome. Now, I think I only need four of the slime balls. I got six. Now, let's see if I can do this from memory and have it actually work. Or let's see if the recipe's changed, more likely. Oh, nope, there we go. Slimy mud. We're gonna go here. Pull that out, put two saplings in, and toss that in there. And wait for it. Okay. Pop that back in. And slime crystal. Awesome. Let's say rubber sapling? Sure. And we go here now. And trees of slime. Manual submit. Two slime saplings. Liquid XP tank. And artifact. Let's take the one in the middle. I don't think it's going to make a lot of difference, really, which one I get. Gold dagger of repair. Repairs other items when used. Cool. I don't know how well it'll work with Tinker stuff, though. That's what 90% of what I have is right now, is Tinkers. And let's put those in there, I guess. And the quarter hearts can go away. Liquid XP tank, number I need 24 levels. 24, unlock. Need 26. It's going to be tight. I might make it. No, I made it 24. There we go. All right. So that is actually, my inventory is looking a lot nicer now. Okay, fused quartz, though. I put you in here. I need 8 of you, because I need 2 pieces of fused quartz. So you are going to go in there. Put one in at a time, I guess. Because it runs for 13 minutes. Yeah, and it's burning down a lot faster than I like here. We're down to what, 1 iron ingot? Oof, just 1. Damn. Alright, and thank you. And we'll put you in there. Could have sworn I already had some blue slime balls. I did. I had a lot of blue slime balls. Whoa, okay. I have 14 of them now. Whoops. Let's put, like, the oak wood away, too. I don't need it. Oh, yes. You should be done now. Cool. Casting basin. Check. Faucet. Check. And right here. There's no hole on the drain, but you can still pull fluids out of it. Where did... There we go. And there's our block of steel. We got 34 ingots of gold in there from all that stuff we got. Oh, yes. Vines. Been growing some. Because that one quest is repeatable. So... Okay, so fused quartz. Are you done? You're done. Nice. And it didn't take that much power either. Alright, you are empty, so you should work. Manual submit. Awesome. Let's grab... I'm just going to grab the artifact tools, I guess. And reinforced tank. Because I don't really need armor. I've got this stuff, and I'd like it. I mean, unless it's something that outputs light, which I doubt it. Put that way. And you are Excavator's Gold Amulet of Flight. Invisibility when used for 30 seconds. Reduced vision while invisible. Shoots fireballs when inflicting damage. Digs big holes. Slows down all mobs when dropped. Allows sneaking on air when held. That, and it didn't take any durability to do that. Okay, then. I like that item. That item's nice. All right, so that one's done. That's done. QED. Let's look at this guy now. QED. All right. This is going to be kind of spendy. Eye of Ender times 2. 5 Ender-infused obsidian. And... So I need 6 ender-infused obsidian, okay? Because I need 1 for the diamond-etched computational matrix. 4 burnt quartz. Well, that would be 8. That's 2 of them right there. Do I have more? Like another quartz ore? Okay, I have 6 here. Close enough. Toss you in there. And... Which backpack is this one? Yes. Block of quartz there. So, like so. Kind of wait for this guy. Oh, how much is in here? 3. I just need 1 piece of quartz out of you. Thank you. We'll transfer you like so. Put you in here. No, it's a waste of charcoal or coal. I don't care. At this point, I really don't. Where is my... That's my oak wood. Rubber wood should be in here, right? 40 of it. You are going to get to cracking on making some charcoal for me. So, ender-infused obsidian. I need 4 obsidian. Good news, bad news. I don't have any obsidian. I do have 3 ender portals, though. That can go in there. Let's see. I do have 1 eye of ender, which I got from... Actually, one of the Lady Asta ores I found, which is awesome. Lady Asta Osto. I need to... still haven't quite... Let's get Porky's Gold Ring of Trapping, too. And I need at least 1 more blaze powder. Thing is I only have the one blaze rod here, which I could get more. I do randomly see blazes show up. So, and I guess my next stop's going to be the Nether anyway. So there's that. I have exactly enough. Now I need to go get like 8 pieces of obsidian. Okay, you're done cooking up. You can go in there. You should be done. Yep, there's my burnt quartz. Now I just need some ender-infused obsidian and a diamond. Oh, look at that. You're done. All's up in here is gold. Yep. 34 ingots. Ah, dang it. So now you, I'm just going to uncraft. So that way you stack with the ingots we have. So we got 13 of you. That's good. I like that. Sure, you. I'm one level short. Okay. Alright, obsidian time. And I'm using this bucket so that way I can pick up the water source. With the infinite water bucket, it doesn't... You can't pick it back up. Yes, this is where my grass is. It's right here. I didn't see that one coming at all, actually. Apparently John Cena's don't show up on the map. Actually, no, those things just have an insane explosion radius. I mean, I lost all that experience. Alright. Oh, I forgot I don't have auto step on anymore. Level 17 now. I was at 25. Alright, we got my stuff. Let's put that down. Because that freaking John Cena was over here when he blew up. So, screw you, game. Actually, that's screw you, you know, mod pack. Alright, and I am going to seal that back up too. Start equipping stuff again. There's that. Put my torch on. There's a zombie outside. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, that'll work. Don't really need the quest book on the hotbar. I will do that though. Alright, let's go get something to eat first. Fill up my saturation so that way I can heal maybe. Because I didn't heal up to full amount. 81%. Okay, that's kind of close on the burgers. But they were a dungeon find, so. There we go. Well, back up to level 18 now. Okay, how did you get in? Oh, you're one of those stupid mining zombies, aren't you? You asshole. What'd you break? No? How did you get in then? Was it dark enough like right here? That you could spawn or something? Or did you somehow have to figure out how to open an iron door from the outside? Alright. I had a bit of a water leak earlier, so. Oh, hi. Yeah, you are here. There you go. You're dead. How are these things doing anyway? 238. I don't think these knives are ever going to get good, so to speak. Oh, hi. See, I can do that if I have a regular water bucket, which is nice. Oh, come on. And, oh God, this is slow. All right, cool. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Okay, I am starting to suffocate down here. Proximity to lava will do that to you, so. Going back up. Yep, okay. Now the thing is to make sure those damn leaves don't catch on fire. Do 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 do. And you know, I could go get my straw. Nah. Done that before, so. I think I'm just gonna make everybody suffer through watching the mine obsidian. Oh well. But I am almost fully healed now, which is nice. I really don't like how the more hurt you are, the longer it takes to heal. Because there are skeletons out there that'll shoot you with an arrow with poison 3 on it. What poison 3 does to your health? Basically, it pins it down and says, you got a pretty mouth, okay? Poison 3 is an incredibly horrible, horrible enchantment to be hit with. Drops you to half a heart. In like 4 seconds, maybe, I think. And then it takes you 10 minutes to heal. And, alright, what are we at now? We're at six, so I need two more. See? Yep, the lava just freaking, or the obsidian just fell. Thank you. Yeah, it will fall, which sucks. Especially, you know, with the lava pools. Because you just deleted the block of lava that was underneath it as well. Thank you. And this last one. Pretty please get out of here without things going horribly wrong. Again. And boom. Thank you. All right, let's get out of here. Except if something goes bad. Like another freaking John Cena creeper showing up. That's just, I hate those things with a passion. There's just no reason for them to exist. It's just, I hate it because it's like, boom, you're dead. Oh, I'm sorry, you wanted to survive. No, you're dead. There's nothing you can do about it. Okay, I need that, and I think I put my burnt quartz in here. Yep, here we go. Cool. All right. Oh, I need to make my ender infused obsidian first. There we go. Oops. Oh, like so. Thank you. Damage computational matrix. All right. Oh, I need four diamonds for this. Oof, that's spendy. I mean, I can do it, but a little spendier than I thought it would be. There we go. There's that. Let's make ourselves a crafting table because it wants that as well. And then we go like so. Thank you much. There is our QED. Which I'm not going to put down yet. However, now to look at the quest book. And boom, that is done. We got ourselves an Enderflux crystal, which is what powers the QED. And so actually I'm going to put this guy, like, let's put him right there for now, I guess. Enderflux crystal. Now, I need two pieces of coal and my two shiny ore, so. Okay, sometimes you can kind of spam it a bit on the scroll wheel trick and have it actually move some stuff down there. There we go. You can hear from the sounds of the particles. It's now fired up. It's going to take its sweet time, but you know, it is what it is. It is a little creepy the first time you hear it. Sorry, I seem to have a bit of the sniffles this morning too. So that's 7 ingots. Okay, so I can't get any more blocks of gold out of there. Well, damn. Anything else? Oh, I got a couple more of you. Sweet. Level 20. Got another egg. Let's try this out. Nope. Okay. I'm still at like 50% for having the damn chickens pop out of those things, though. Get ourselves some more sugarcane, which I'm not sure what I'm. Wait a second. Sugarcane. I can make punji sticks. Ooh, hey now. All right, let's go check the damage. Oh. Hi. And of course, your silverfish. All right. Come on. Come here and say hi. Oh, and I got another one of those guys. Ooh, thank you. Okay. I think I had a drowning creeper blow up, is what happened. Did not mean to leave the door open. I only meant to hit it once, not twice. Oh, would your body parts get out of here? I'm thinking about getting rid of that mod because it's annoying as hell. Oh, hi. Thank you. You're dead? Awesome. Use grass to feed sheep. Yeah, well, I need sheep first. Okay. Yep. That was a drowning creeper blew up right there. Nice. This is what I hate. The creepers will blow up. I mean, I was nowhere close to that jerk. And he went boom. So, I mean, come on here. Game, fix your crap. All right, cool. We got three shiny ingots on. It's working on the other three. First things first. Oh, with that, I'm going to make a new pick head and a new sword. So let's go back to survival. Go here, and it is a consume task, unfortunately. And I'm going to choose the ripple bag on the left. All right, let's put some crap away. We got like six of those things now. I don't need this partial bow. Put that away as well. Got more bones. 58 bones, damn. A good bag with a clock, which that's where that came from. Got tired of staring at a clock in my go away. Staring at a clock in my chest, and I'm like, all right, I'll do something with it. So I made a clock out of it. Now I have another one. Thank you. I shall treasure it never. Okay, so yeah, we got my shiny ingots here. I'm going to toss those in here to start melting down, actually. Then later on, off camera, I'll make the sword blade. And my, okay, that is done now. And my new pickaxe head. 95% complete. What is left? This one has been completed already. Okay. Do the creep. And the bomb squad. That's it. Both of them require killing creepers. I don't know. Is there an alternate recipe for TNT? Five gunpowder, four sand. That's it, huh? I'm not sure I trust the TNT from the Hardcore Ender expansion either. Oh, we got six berries that time. That's cool. Back up to level 23. Let's not do something stupid like go to investigate noises or anything. But I think I'm going to go ahead and call this an episode. I've almost completed Survival, which is chapter one. And I wonder how I unlock We Must Go Deeper then, because maybe at the end of For Science? Okay, well, let's see. What do we have? Survival's Generator. And then, oh God. I'm going to have to make both of those. All right, I'm going to look at that furnace, though. What does it take to make the redstone furnace? Because I kind of eclipsed it already. I made the Alloy Smelter. That's pretty standard though. Redstone, bricks, copper gears, reception coil, and it's a servo, which is a 10 gear and 8 redstone. Okay, so that's a little more spendy, but then it's glass and iron. All right. Reinforced, resonant, basic. Yep, okay, I can use basics with it. Copper gears, which, okay. Well, the reception coil is the same, and the copper gears are the same. Cool, I might as well make one, I guess. And we got our two ingots of molten shiny. I kind of sort of want to do this icosahedron though. I guess I can go out this way. And let's see. Waypoints. Let's get rid of that. Let's come on down to, like, say, here, just in case it does something that results in an explosion. Put it down. Click it. Okay, what the hell? Where's the rain of fire coming from? Because I know it's not the icosahedron. Dang it. And I don't know what the icosahedron did now. I don't even know where this jerk is that's shooting at me. Okay. Whoop. Where the hell? Oh, hi. There he is. Woo! Cool. He's dead now? Awesome. Can I go outside and get some stuff now? Now, I don't even know what it did. That's annoying. Because that jerk showed up before it was even done spinning. So, I think that one was kind of... Okay, hi. There we go. That's how you end off an episode, right? Well, thank you for joining me. Until next time, Science signing out. Have fun.